May be seated. Good afternoon. My name is Frank Warhol. I am the captain of operations here at the police department. But before we get started, I just want to take a moment to acknowledge some of the city officials that are here today. Right over here to my left, we have two of our commissioners. I have Commissioner Joe Inosco and Commissioner Brenna Kavanaugh. And I'd also like to introduce to you our command staff, along with Chief of Police Dave Mara. And also I have Patrol Division Lieutenant Mike Maloney. Professional Standards Lieutenant Darren Sargent, excuse me, and Investigation Division Lieutenant Mark Newport, and Operations Support Lieutenant Chris Cummings. It is my pleasure now to invite Chief Mara to the podium.
Good afternoon. It's great to see everybody here. This is a big day for Portsmouth Police Department. We are going to, with the hiring of these two young men, we are now going to have 63 police officers. By the beginning of this year, early this coming year, we are going to have 64 police officers. It's an addition of two officers from a previous complement. And I need to thank the police commission, the city council, as well as the city manager for working with us on our previous budget so we were able to hire two more police officers. Now, we're not going to see these officers out in the street for another 9 months. They're going to go to the State Academy. All New Hampshire police officers have to be certified through the same academy, so they'll go up to police standards and training in Concord. Currently, I believe it's a 16-week program. Then after they come back from there, they are now going to be in our field training program. So approximately 9 months will be the time that we will see them out there. And it's a long process to become a Portsmouth police officer. It starts with a written test. It then a physical agility test. Then after that, there is an initial interview, then another interview. Then there's everything from a medical examination, a written psych examination, a face-to-face psych examination, and a polygraph examination as well. We take our time in selecting people because we want to make sure that we get the right person to wear this uniform. And that's especially important when you see what's going on across the country, where you see in some parts of the countries and communities that distrust of officers, that mistakes are made, that one mistake can bring a whole community against your police department. So that is why we take our time, we make sure we get the right people. And I think the people that we currently have in the police department is a testament to the process that we have. And I can tell you that I had the opportunity to have long conversations with these two young men. And I'm very happy to say I believe that they're going to fit in fine, and I think they're going to be very good police officers. And it's not an easy job. So when you get on, you have to listen to the people that have already been here before you, ask questions, learn, and then go out there, and you have to have contact with the community. The community has to look at you as a friend, as part of the community. We're a community police organization, and we expect our officers to be our ambassadors. We expect our officers not only to be ambassadors of the police department, but the city of Portsmouth as a whole. So with that, we'll get on with the swearing in, and welcome to the police department.
The two gentlemen you're about to meet have gone through a rigorous selection process to be selected and hired as a Portsmouth police officer. After extensive screening, we choose the best candidates to enter the ranks of your police department to assure they are mentally and physically ready to accept the rigorous demands of this profession. As the chief just stated, these young men have completed physical and medical evaluations, multiple oral interviews, and extensive background investigation, which includes a polygraph examination and a psychological examination. At this time, I would like to call Officer Joseph Melanson to stand up next to me. Mm-hmm. Joe is a graduate of Brewster Academy and is currently matriculating at both Granite State College and the Community College of the Air Force in pursuit of his criminal justice degree. Joe joined the New Hampshire Air Guard National Guard in 2013 and is currently an active member. He received the Top Airman Award out of 400 trainees and was an academic honor graduate from the Air Force Academy. After graduation, he immediately entered the Security Forces Academy for Military Police and was a distinguished graduate there as well. Joe came to us from Rockingham County Department of Corrections, where he received a Lifesaver Award for heroic actions on two separate occasions in the course of the same week. Before working full-time in law enforcement, Joe managed the Wildcat Fitness Center in Durham. He did an internship with the Dover Police at the Teen Center and is a graduate of the 2013 Portsmouth Police Citizen Police Academy. At this time, I'd like to call up Officer Jack Maloney. Jack was born and raised in Lowell, Massachusetts. Just this month, Jack graduated from the University of Massachusetts Lowell with a degree in criminal justice. As a junior in high school, he started a landscaping business, which he still runs today, in addition to working as a crew foreman for a second landscaping business. Jack is a graduate of the Massachusetts Reserve Police Academy and has worked as a special traffic officer for the town of Chelmsford, Massachusetts. In 2012, he worked as a counselor for the Lowell Police Youth Academy, working with and mentoring youth in grades 5 through 8. He is also a volunteer coach in the Chelmsford Police Athletic League and has received awards 2 years in a row for outstanding and dedicated service to the Chelmsford Auxiliary Police Unit. Chief, you can come on up.
If you both could please raise your right hands. You solemnly swear that you will faithfully and impartially discharge and perform all the duties incumbent upon you as a police officer for the city of Portsmouth according to the best of your ability, agreeable to the rules and regulations of the constitutions and laws of the state of New Hampshire, so help you God.
Yes, sir, I do.
Congratulations.
At this time, I'm going to ask Officer Melanson to let us know who you want to have come up and pin your badge on.
My wife, Brittany Melanson.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Time if Officer Maloney could come up. And Officer Maloney, who would you like to come up to pin your badge on?
My father, Dirk Maloney.
Portsmouth Police Department would now like to recognize two outstanding officers who were promoted to special details earlier this year. At this time, I'd like to call Training Officer Eric Benson and Detective Seth Tondro to come to the podium. Officer Benson has been a Portsmouth police officer since 2006. Before that, he was a member of the United States Coast Guard Reserve and was activated several times in the wake of 9/11 and deployed along the Eastern Seaboard. Eric was promoted to the special details position as the police department's training officer in May, but due to staffing shortages in patrol, he was not able to assume full-time responsibilities until recently. He's a field training officer, a certified instructor in firearms, defensive tactics instructor, taser, expandable baton, OC spray, tactical shield, and a specialized civilian response to active shooter events protocol. Eric is also a member of the Seacoast Emergency Response Team. Officer Benson is the recipient of the Portsmouth Police Life-Saving Medal for his actions at the scene of Brentwood Officer Stephen Arkell's shooting death in 2014. Detective Seth Tondro came to us from the Epping Police Department in 2010 and has 10 years of law enforcement experience. Seth was on the dean's list at Northeastern and graduated magna cum laude from Fitchburg State College with a degree in criminal justice. Like Eric, Seth was promoted to detective in May of this year, but remained in patrol until recently because of staffing shortages in that division. Detective Tondro is also the Red Cross Hero recipient for saving an individual's life with CPR when he worked for Epping PD. Seth is a field training officer, a physical fitness instructor, a member of the department's honor guard, crime scene team, motorcycle unit, and currently serves as the president of the Portsmouth Police Relief Association. Seth is an assistant team leader on the Seacoast Emergency Response Team. Congratulations, gentlemen. Chief.
And I want to personally thank both of these men for what they have done for the department. As you heard, that they became respectively a detective and a training officer back in May. But again, due to some manpower problems and issues that we had, they stayed in patrol. They continued to report for their duty, their shifts. But also in addition to that, for instance, we had one officer continue to do his duties in patrol, but also on his own accord, he would go into training and he would perform duties there as well. And the same thing with Detective Tondro. He would go his normal duties in patrol, and then he'd go to detectives, and he'd also work there as well and get ready so when he made the move. And I'd just like to tell you gentlemen that these are two men that and officers that you certainly should set as an example and you know, wish to aspire to be like. They are what a Portsmouth Police Department is all about. So I want to thank both of you, and congratulations belatedly. Okay, that concludes our ceremony. And again, I'd like to welcome all of you to the Portsmouth Police family. Please keep your family involved. Let them know how things are going. Talk about the job. Sometimes as time goes on, it's good to be able to let your family, they worry about you, let them know what you're feeling and what's going on in your career. And I'd also like to thank the training division. Lieutenant Cummings has done a great job. We've hired 10 people this year, and you've already heard about the process for all the people that we keep. There's a lot more that have gone through the process that didn't make the grade. So it's a lot of work, everything from the polygraphs, Sergeant, where is he? Right there, Sergeant Paraki. He does all our polygraphs, and as you can see, he takes our ceremony pictures as well. And also, all the officers and supervisors who do the background, they also are a big part of this as well. So thank you for coming, and congratulations. Thanks.